Greetings! Today we're doing carbon fiber part 2 on the Focus RS. So these are the two parts for carbon fiber part 2 in my RS. So we've got this bit, which is really the star of the show for this one. The Genuine 4 Parts Handbrake Grip in carbon fiber. Absolutely glorious. This of course is the piece that you get as standard in the editions, so the blue, red and heritage editions. So now it's going to be in my AR edition, if you like. And then this piece is just a little bit of carbon fiber. It goes sort of just underneath where this goes, so it makes sense. It's just a piece of carbon fiber with some sticky bits on the bottom, but you'll see where that goes once we get that into the car. Now, before we go and put these into the car, I'm going to do a little bit of preparation work to make sure that they're nice and protected for the future. So what I'm going to use is this ceramic coating from Carbon Collective called Oracle. So this is a pretty versatile ceramic coating. We can use it on our carbon fiber. You can use it on all sorts of paint finishes, internal and external on a vehicle, including carbon fiber and also significantly including bare metal. So that means that we don't have to tape this bit up and stop it from getting on it. We can just go ahead and seal the whole thing. So the way this works is we're going to use one of the provided little pad things, a few drops on here, wipe it around, and then we're going to immediately use microfiber cloth to remove the excess because the bond begins immediately. And then we leave that for about 2 hours, and then we come back and repeat the process, and that is that. Okay, so open it up. Good to wear gloves for this. Few drops. I'll start with this piece. Just back and forth, overlapping. All right, so that is literally it. You need to buff off the excess within 1 to 2 minutes because, like I said, it does start its bond immediately. So a light buff with a nice quality, clean microfiber. Of course, these items need to be clean. If you follow me on Instagram, you'll know that I had to do some prep on this, but it got it nice and ready for this process. Okay, so that looks pretty good. So now I just set this to the side and wait for 2 hours. Okay, so now we can move on to the star of the show, the actual grip itself. So this is fresh. Repeat the exact same process. A few drops on there, not too much. Okay, cool. So I just have this random like bracket thing just lying around, which is sort of weighty enough to stay upright. And then I'm gonna just pop that on there and wait for 2 hours. Then after 2 hours, like I said before, repeat the exact same process and we'll be ready to install these into the car. So we're gonna do this piece first and then we'll move on to the handbrake grip. So this just sits right underneath the handbrake. You can kind of see if we come in, there's like a contour where like the panels join together, which this piece just sort of matches up with. So that's where it's going. Just a little bit of extra pizzazz, a little bit of extra spice. So this sticks on just exactly the same as the carbon fiber part one bits, just a couple of like sticky strips. So we're gonna heat those up in a minute, but first we're gonna prep the area. And to do that, we're gonna use an alcohol wipe, just degrease, clean it up, get it all nice and prepped to stick down onto. So that alcohol is kind of wet, but it'll dry quite quickly because it's alcohol. But while that is drying, we'll get this warmed up. So I've got this set to 25 degrees. I pressed my little man's face, which means it's going to start coming out here. I've only just turned the car on, so it's still kind of cold. So once it's warm, then I'll just hold this up to it, get it heated up. Just get it down there. Try and position it where you want it. Just try and position it. It is kind of awkward to position, of course. So that looks pretty good. And I'm just going to push directly down and apply pressure and just hold it here. Probably at least a good couple of minutes. Probably just hold it for as long as I can, really, until my arms get tired from holding it down. And then that should be good to go, and we'll be able to move on to the handbrake grip. So just hold them side by side. You can see roughly the difference. This one obviously looks girthier just straight out the box, and just holding it in my hand, it feels girthier than that, which is pretty nice. Everyone likes a nice bit of extra girth. So before we actually get to putting this on, obviously we need to take the stock part off. So I'll just put this away for a sec. Right, so the first part is we take our like gaiter thing here and sort of just pull it down. So yeah, just get a grip and then just sort of like pull it. There we go. And when you do that, you reveal this like clippy thing, and this is what is holding it on. So it's kind of like metal and then like a ridge, and then this plastic clip is just kind of over the ridge. So we kind of need to pry this upward and then sort of shimmy the grip off. So to do that, we're gonna sort of use a screwdriver. Gonna get a screwdriver in there and just kind of start jiggling this back and forth just whilst we apply that upward pressure on the clip, and eventually it should pop over it. You can see it's kind of starting to go. There we go. So that's the work with the screwdriver done. So we're over the ridge and we're loose. So we just kind of just get a grip on it and shimmy it off. Oy, there we go. So now you can clearly see that little ridge. It's just kind of like literally just a little ridge in the metal. So we do need to hold on to the actual end button thing, so that should just pop right out like that. So now we can get rid of this. We can actually do a better side by side now. So obviously construction is the same apart from the material used to bind it, but yeah, it's gonna look good. Okay, so just need to slide this on, give it a wee shimmy, and get the clip over the metal ridge. So you can see our clip is just over our metal ridge, so that is it in place. So now we take our stock button, it just slides over this plastic end bit, and that's literally it. Good stuff. So now the only thing that's left is our little gaiter thing. So it kind of just goes up and around. Using some tweezers to help. So there we go, that is our two pieces for carbon fiber part two in my Focus RS. Looking absolutely fantastic, feeling absolutely fantastic, and I think really complementing each other. You could probably do the grip by itself and it would still look awesome, but I think adding that wee bit just sets it off real nice. So yeah, I hope you like that. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please do like, share, and subscribe for more content to come very, very soon. Thank you once again. Goodbye.